So I recently published a pretty long, 7,500 word long profile of William Vollmann for the New Republic, and the opening anecdote is my attempt as a 26-year-old editor to convince him to cut 1,000 pages out of Rising Up and Rising Down so I could publish it when I was a boy editor at Henry Holt in 2000. I failed, obviously, and the book came out 3 years later from McSweeney's in a glorious and legendary edition, 7-volume edition, that now, copies of which now sell for close to $1,000 on Amazon. I have one. But what's funny about this is that right after the piece came out, I got an editor from Eli Horowitz, who was, in fact, the editor on the McSweeney's edition of that book. And he sent me a letter saying how part of him wished that Vollmann had consented to go with me and Henry Holt, because he still had like a mild form of post-traumatic stress disorder from editing the book, because it was just so long and took such a gargantuan chunk out of his life that, you know, he just, it's kind of a just a blur. Imagine line editing that book. I mean, it's like trying to imagine building St. Peter's Basilica brick by brick. The funny thing about Bill, I think, is that he's one of the only writers I know that actually seems like a character in his own books. Like, Nabokov kind of seems like a character in a Nabokov novel, and Bill, I think, feels like a character in a William Vollmann book. And there are very few writers I can think that's true to say that of. And I feel like he's the most interesting person to write a profile of, because there's so much stuff I had to leave out. Like, whole swaths of fascinating things about his life, once you get past the war correspondence and the Unabomber problem and the, you know, the fact that he's a pretty amazing and accomplished visual artist. And the fact that he's written, you know, 23 books, half of which are over 1,000 pages long. The fact that the draft I wrote of this 7,500 word article, the first draft where I was just trying to get all the information in, was like 80 pages long. That alone should tell you that William Vollmann is someone that is a blessing to write about and a curse to write about.